Slowly but surely, it's becoming leak season. Modern Warfare 2 reveal is right around the corner. It could be happening as soon as the end of this month, within the next week or so. Okay, maybe it's not fair of me to say that it's becoming leak season, because Modern Warfare 2 has been getting leaks for the past year. It's been like a non-stop leak fest for certain aspects of the game. Whether it comes to its UI down to its gameplay elements, there have been many things that have leaked. And I think it's safe to say, as we draw closer to the official reveals, a lot more of the information that gets leaked before the reveals will turn out to be true, because many of these people have inside sources. And that brings us to today's fine conversation surrounding information that was released earlier this morning by the Ghost of Hope. This morning, some pretty big information was dropped, and if you saw the title of this video, then you should know exactly where this conversation is going. The Intervention and ACR are allegedly both in Modern Warfare 2. For those that have been playing Call of Duty for a very long time, you should know by now that these are some of the most iconic weapons in Modern Warfare history. Some reasons are good, some reasons are bad. Pretty much just comes down to bad because they were so extremely powerful. And at the time, we really didn't care too much about that type of stuff. There really wasn't as much complaining about weapon balance back in the day as there is now. This is definitely an interesting thing to see though, because this can really go one of two ways. Obviously, we have these iconic weapons. They come back in Modern Warfare 2. They work extremely well, but maybe they work a little bit too well. They're a little bit too powerful, and then they get changed, and then people are like, no, I want them to go back. I want them to go back to when they were powerful, like a laser beam, and it's just not going to be the same experience, so I think we should all kind of keep our expectations in check, you know, if this does end up coming true. The other thing that Hope mentioned this morning is that there's only going to be 5 attachments on guns in Modern Warfare 2. I think it's safe to assume that the Gunsmith is now a staple of the Call of Duty series. It's most likely not going to go anywhere anytime soon, so I would expect it to be there in all of the games moving forward, especially if it's still going to be linked to Warzone in some capacity. Modern Warfare going back down to 5 attachments as opposed to the 10 that we get currently in Vanguard, I don't feel like that's a bad choice at all. In fact, I feel like that is going to allow developers to keep those balances in check, those buffs and those nerfs, and, you know, keeping an eye on those attachments. It's probably a little bit easier to deal with 5 attachments as opposed to 10, which creates over-the-top weaponry experiences. But what I would personally like to see with the Gunsmith is maybe a perk that allows you to take 5 additional attachments, kind of similar to the perk back in Modern Warfare 2 called Bling. I figure since we're talking about the Intervention and the ACR, we might as well bring that perk up. But that allowed you to take more attachments on your weapons. If they were to do that, that'd be great. You know, that's one of the main reasons why I really appreciated the pick 10 system and the pick 13 system from previous games. You could swap out perks, secondary weapons, and attachments to take more attachments for a single weapon. You could take the wild cards and put even more on there. But now with Call of Duty, you don't have to sacrifice anything to take those attachments. And I think a lot of people enjoy that, including myself. But if you were to surpass 5 of them, I think adding an additional perk or something to go along with that would help. But that's just an idea that I had. I don't think that they're going to end up doing that for the sake of balancing like we just got done mentioning. But this does bring some implications to Warzone. Now, I'm not talking about the current Warzone as we have it today. We have to look forward to the future Modern Warfare 2's version of Warzone 2. I think they're going to be dropping it back down to 5 attachments, and they're probably going to keep it that way. I don't think they had a good time going from 5 attachments to 10 attachments with the Vanguard weaponry and creating a weird mess of balancing when it comes to those weapons being able to have 10 attachments and the other weapons not being able to have them. They want to keep it on a balanced playing field, no matter if the weapon came from the future or the past. You know, having additional attachments can really change up the specific effects of that weapon, both from recoil to damage to range to, you know, bullet velocity, and all of this goes hand in hand with the gameplay. But this isn't like news, you know, this has been happening for a while now. It's kind of always been this way in Call of Duty. People gravitate towards the most powerful weapons. That is the point of the game, after all, being able to take out the enemy before they take you out, so having the most powerful weapon makes sense. But I was also just thinking about a rumor I remember hearing like towards the end of last year. It was like right before we ended up getting the release of Vanguard. There was a rumor floating around that internally at Infinity Ward, there was discussion happening about whether or not they should be as strict on weapon balancing I'm guessing this is probably something that happens during the conceptualizing phase of like multiplayer. Like, I'm sure that they're, you know, actively working on things all the time, but that just kind of reminds me of like the MW2 days where it was a free-for-all when it came to certain weapons because there was just no updates happening in that game. Now, I'm simply just saying that was a rumor that I remember hearing a long time ago, and things have most likely, most definitely changed. But it is definitely pretty interesting to consider the idea, what if they weren't as strict on weapon balancing in the full-fledged multiplayer? That would cause a lot of issues, though, I'm sure. Like, if there was one weapon that was better than everything else for the entire year, like the ACR, oh my gosh, that would be crazy. Another thing that ended up coming out a few hours ago was patch notes from the Treyarch team. April 25th is going to bring the Black Ops Cold War update that drops a brand new location, a new secret location, offering over a dozen rewards and a permanent upgrade in all zombie maps, depending on how many main quests you've completed. We're also going to be seeing some changes to Outbreak. Tombstone is actually going to work now, so the Tier 4 upgrade is going to work, and the Mystery Box is going to be updated with Season 6 weapons. I do want to take a second to talk a little bit about this all-new secret location. Over the past week, I went ahead and cleaned up all of the different Easter eggs that I hadn't done, so when it finally does come out, I'll be able to jump into this secret location and show you guys footage of it, whatever it happens to be. But this is probably going to be a location that's added directly into one of the maps. The question is, which map is it going to be added to? Will you be able to go to this location straight away, or are you going to have to complete a couple of different steps of a new Easter egg? That's the really confusing part to me. They also make it seem like it's going to be gated off, depending on, you know, how many different main quests you've completed. So is it going to be like one long tunnel with these gates that just open and open and open until finally you get to the end and that reward is there? They also kind of made it seem like you need to pick the rewards up in order to earn them. And what could the permanent reward be? Is it going to be on the level of Infinite Warfare Zombies? I'm completely unsure about that, but I'm definitely here for it. I am 100% here for it, and I can't wait to see just exactly what is in store for all of us that completed the main quests in Black Ops Cold War. I'll keep you all posted right here on the channel, like I mentioned before. So on the 25th, I'll have an update video showing what you have to do, if you have to do anything, where the location is, and we'll do a bunch of exploring and just check out all the different rewards. Over a dozen rewards and a permanent upgrade. That has me scratching my head. Leave your thoughts down below in the comments section. What do you think that permanent upgrade could be in all of the zombie maps, depending on how many main quests you've completed? Oh boy, let me know. Thank you guys for watching. That's all I got to say in this video today. If you enjoyed the conversation, please consider leaving a like on this video. It takes a second of your time and it helps out the channel. If you haven't yet, don't forget to click the subscribe button. I upload pretty much every single day, and I look forward to making more videos for you throughout the week. So stay tuned for that, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.